Nikola Tesla was a man of his word. He said he could build power generators better than those of Thomas Edison. He built them. Tesla said he did not need copper wires to deliver power. Electricity could be transmitted through the air. He proved that it could. Tesla told us of other mechanisms of miracle. What were his most outrageous inventions, and how were they lost? Nikola Tesla did not draw blueprints for his inventions. He merely pictured them in his mind. When he put together the parts of a new machine, he worked exclusively from memory. Tesla never wrote anything down except as an afterthought. But it is known where he kept his most important documents. In a standalone safe, which he kept in the posh New York City hotel room in which he lived. In 1898, at the Manhattan address he was using as a laboratory, Tesla manufactured a small device he attached to one of the building's load-bearing steel columns. It was an oscillating piston driven by compressed air, and it was less than 3 feet long. He only tested the oscillator once, during a visit by the famous American author, Mark Twain. In a frightening example of forced resonance, the pulsation of the oscillator matched the natural structural frequency of the building's bricks. Cracking plaster ceilings, breaking windows, and bursting water pipes. Number 46 East Houston Street was shaken so vigorously that it caused a local neighborhood earthquake. On the sound advice of Samuel Clemens to destroy the device before it was discovered by the authorities, Tesla disconnected it with a sledgehammer and requested that his guest claim ignorance as to the cause of the tremors. The superintendent of New York City schools in 1912 was William Maxwell. Over dinner with Tesla, he mentioned his difficulty educating the city's underachievers. 3 days later, the inventive genius appeared in the doorway of Maxwell's office with a solution to the problem. "The next time you build a school," Tesla told him, "I recommend the installation of special cable wires to be hidden in the classroom walls for the purpose of carrying high-frequency voltage. This will convert your classrooms into baths of electromagnetism, vibrating at a rate which stimulates the mental powers of the young." He advised the superintendent to make every effort to keep the experiment a secret. Maxwell approved the plan. However, its results never showed up in the newspapers. It is said that a school which still operates in Brooklyn, which is now called the William H. Maxwell High School, was the building equipped with Tesla's experimental cabling. It was constructed in 1912. Finally, the brilliant inventor told reporters in 1933 that he developed an apparatus to record images directly from the human brain. Thoughts were recorded by special motion photography of the retina of the human eye, where the brain's innermost thoughts are reflected visually. Tesla expected this new tool to replace the polygraph as the most accurate lie detector on the market. How were these inventions lost? A year and 1 month after the United States entered World War II, Nikola Tesla died of a heart attack, alone, in his room on the top floor of the Hotel New Yorker. His nephew, Sava Kasanovich, immediately traveled from Yugoslavia to claim the estate. Sadly, at that time, Yugoslavia was on the same side as the Axis powers of Japan and Germany. Kasanovich was suspected of holding public office in a government under Nazi occupation. In 2016, the FBI declassified its investigation into the death of Nikola Tesla. Documents released through the Freedom of Information Act revealed that, shortly after his death, Sava Kasanovich was the first person to look for Tesla's research papers. Kasanovich went to Tesla's hotel suite, and he was accompanied by a locksmith. Papers were removed from the safe. 97% of these documents have never been released, for his papers are now in the overseas archives of the Nikola Tesla Museum and are unavailable for viewing by the public. Even to the citizens of the museum's host city, Belgrade.
It's not a classic.